By digesting food, the body breaks it into various nutrients and waste products. As the waste material moves through the colon, it gradually forms into feces. The large intestine contains a diverse community of bacteria that aid in the final stages of digestion. These bacteria break down complex molecules, releasing gases such as ammonia and methane. These compounds have a strong, unpleasant odor that can intensify the smell of feces. When the body breaks down proteins, it releases sulfur compounds like hydrogen sulfide. These byproducts have a distinct rotten egg smell. Also, the breakdown of fats can produce short-chain fatty acids. These acids contribute to the pungent smell of feces. Red blood cells have a lifespan of about 120 days. When red blood cells reach the end of their life, they are broken down in a process called hemolysis. A yellow-orange pigment called bilirubin is formed as a byproduct of this process. Bilirubin is then transported to the liver and excreted into the bile. Bile is a digestive fluid produced by the liver and stored in the gallbladder. Bile plays a crucial role in the digestion and absorption of fats. Bilirubin gives the bile its typical yellowish-green to dark greenish-brown color. When we eat a meal that contains fats, the gallbladder contracts, releasing the concentrated bile through the bile duct into the duodenum, along with other components of bile. Bilirubin is released into the intestines. As bilirubin travels through the intestines, it undergoes some chemical changes. Bacteria break down bilirubin in the intestine, resulting in a brown pigment that gives feces its brown color. Also, a portion of bilirubin is converted into urobilinogen by the action of intestinal bacteria. Some urobilinogen is reabsorbed into the bloodstream. And eventually excreted by the kidneys. Giving the urine a yellow color contributes to normal urine's characteristic color. The color of feces can vary depending on the amount of bilirubin present and how it interacts with other components in the digestive system. Certain foods or medications can affect bile production or how bilirubin is metabolized, leading to changes in fecal color. For example, consuming large amounts of beets can cause red or pink-colored stool. Some artificial food dyes or natural pigments found in certain foods can pass through the digestive system without being fully absorbed. They may impart temporary colors to the stool, such as bright red, blue, or green. Certain foods, such as garlic, onions, and certain spices contain sulfur compounds that can be absorbed into the bloodstream and eventually excreted in feces, contributing to an altered or stronger odor. Diets rich in fiber can lead to larger, softer, and bulkier stools. Fiber helps move stool through the digestive tract and supports the growth of certain beneficial gut bacteria, which may influence fecal odor. Consuming adequate fluids and a diet high in fiber can help maintain regular bowel movements and result in well-formed stools. On the other hand, low fiber intake or dehydration can lead to harder, dry stools. Diets high in fat can increase the fat content of feces, making them appear greasy and foul-smelling. This can be observed in conditions like malabsorption or pancreatic disorders. Feces color, odor, and consistency can vary based on individual factors such as diet, hydration, medications, gut microbiota, and overall health. In most cases, changes in fecal characteristics due to diet are regular and temporary. However, if you notice persistent or concerning changes in fecal traits, it's advisable to consult a healthcare professional for evaluation.